One of our top stories, Karnataka ranks first among all the major states of India to administer the first dose of COVID vaccine to the eligible population, followed by Gujarat and Madhya Pradesh. Till 9th December, 94.57% of the 4.89 crore eligible population in the state have been jabbed with the first dose. According to the COVID data, till a week ago, Karnataka was at third position in first dose administration. But now it's followed by Gujarat, which is at 94.46% vaccination, and Madhya Pradesh, which is at 93.83% of the target population who have been covered by the first dose. It's important to mention here that in January, the average vaccination in Karnataka was around a little over 21,000 doses per day. However, the state's daily average vaccinations have shot up to 4,83,144 by September. According to the data, vaccinations picked up further in Karnataka since November 26th, following growing concern over the Omicron variant. So far, three districts, Bengaluru Urban, Gadag and Vijayapura, have achieved 100% coverage in terms of first dose administration. Let me go across to my colleague Neha Hebbale for more on this. Neha, so Karnataka is at the top spot when it comes to first dose administration. Take us through some of the strategies which were taken by the civic body administration in order to achieve this feat. Of course, the Omicron concern also had a role to play.
Well, absolutely, Tonima, that's right. I'll start with the Omicron, and like you rightly mentioned, the concern that it brought along with it and how since then also the vaccination has shot up. It was just about 10 days ago that, you know, that we started actually hearing about Omicron, that the concern started being raised. Yes, while there were talks about it, let's also remind you that Karnataka was the first state that reported the two cases of Omicron in the country. And ever since then also, there has, you know, been a rampant need to ramp up vaccination. And the state government too over here has constantly been urging people to come forward and get vaccinated, and why it's important to get vaccinated as well. Additionally, also, we saw how more stringent measures were imposed soon after the state saw the first two cases of Omicron being reported in the country. We saw several stringent measures being put in place over here, right from the fact that theatres, malls, restaurants, all of them were asked to admit people into their establishments only if they were double vaccinated. So again, you know, we're seeing that was one of the strategies that was used. Apart from that, also largely in several rural areas, we saw quite a few, you know, visuals, startling visuals coming to light where people were seen evading the second dose of vaccination. Also, many people were seen evading the first dose as well. There were people who were pretending to be possessed. There were people who were climbing trees. There was all sorts of madness. But despite that, you know, we saw how health officials did not really lose ground. And, you know, they stayed put and they actually ensured that the vaccinations were administered. However, Tonima, having said this, it's important here to note that this is a very dynamic figure. Yes, while today Karnataka stands at the first position in terms of population vaccinated for the first dose, this is a dynamic figure that keeps changing. It was only a couple of days back that we saw Gujarat had also overtaken Karnataka to be at the top spot. A little while earlier also, we saw Madhya Pradesh also coming very close. And yes, as of December 9th today, it does seem like at the first position in terms of the total population vaccinated, Karnataka does take that top spot. But this is probably likely to change now. Also, let's remind you that with Omicron cases being reported in many other parts of the country, we're likely going to be seeing vaccination going up in other states too.
Right. Let's hope so. And that is, of course, something which not just health experts in the country, but health experts across the world have, in fact, been pushing for, that vaccination coverage should increase, especially amid concerns over the new variant. Neha Hebbale, thank you so much for joining us in that story.